Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am Sid Alpha. I'd promised myself I was going to leave off these videos for a while, allow my channel to stabilize, and allow myself to simply play some video games and have some fun. I even stopped looking at the new releases list quite so much and went back and played some old favorites, games like Mass Effect 2 where I could revisit with Garrus and some other old friends. But after a few hours, my mind kept wandering to that stack of emails I had read but hadn't had a chance to investigate yet. You see, a funny thing happens when you start a YouTube channel that most people never count on. I most certainly wasn't prepared for a good number of aspects. The first was the sense of responsibility and workman's guilt associated with having a YouTube channel. And the sense of responsibility sneaks up on you when the realization finally dawns on you that your channel does have followers. Followers that respect your opinion, even value it, and come to rely on it. It is that realization that drives one to do better, to be hypercritical of one's work. And take this video for example. Right now, I'm working on the fifth incarnation of this video this week, and the reason was the original iteration was less than 5 minutes, and I did want to provide you all not only with some worthwhile information, but some actual meat on the bone, as it were, some genuine content. Now, I know that I'm not the most entertaining person in the world. I would never survive as a stand-up comedian. I do have a fair amount of sarcasm, but there's always the risk of taking things too far. It's easy for me to sort of play around a little during the first impressions videos, to let that sarcasm show a bit, and perhaps to do some entertaining voice as well. But in these videos, I try not to show too much humor because these are serious topics, and I take that mantle, that role of consumer protection, quite seriously, and the topic of asset flippers is not one to be dismissed lightly. These people attempt to cash in on people's ignorance of what they're trying to do, relying on the minimal sales from an extremely inexpensive product that took them zero labor or additional resources to rebrand into their own name. It is disgusting. It is despicable, and I am in a unique position to be able to shed some light on this vile practice, and in the doing so, hopefully save some gamers a few dollars that can be put towards a product and a developer that has actually done something to deserve not only their money, but their time. There is also the sense of workman's guilt that pervades one's consciousness when you have a Twitch stream or a YouTube channel. That constant sense of feeling like, I should be working, or I should be doing a video on this game instead of just playing it. It very much changes your perception of video games and your outlook in relation to them. Now, it is this mindset that drives YouTubers like myself to continually attempt to do better, to make their videos as entertaining or at least as interesting as possible. That is but one of the many definitions of meaningful content. But then we have developers like Crimson Duck who, when they're not busy inventing names for Disney cartoon villains, are churning out a surprising number of asset flips. Now take the game you're seeing on your screen, for example. Slingster, a generic yet decently put together 2D platformer that has a surprising amount of charm to it. So much so that Crimson Duck actually released a sequel to this game a couple of months later titled simply Slingster 2, wherein they decided our green blob of a hero would benefit from a Christmas makeover. Now with these games in particular, I would actually be tempted to give them a positive rating given the polish of the game, the playtime involved, and the price tag. By every indication, it's good value, except that it is indeed merely an asset flip. A meet Super Platformer 2D on the Unity Asset Store. It is a fantastic little kit to be able to be used for you to be able to build your own game off of the back of it, and the original developer did a surprisingly good job, hence some might not suspect that Crimson Duck's versions are not in fact asset flips. And normally, one would be able to leave it there. I would decry the developer's actions and provide a rousing sentiment about the price of freedom being eternal vigilance, except that it doesn't end there. Crimson Duck was not content to end it there. No, they decided to keep going. Our next game on the offering plate is Torch Cave. Again, a simple yet interestingly done 2D platformer that I actually thought had a passable execution. It also even had a sequel as well, Torch Cave 2. And being as I had found the first two games were asset flips, I decided to do some searching, and this one actually took a bit longer to find. It is an asset flip, but this one was a touch more difficult. This is Mr. Mustache Jump'n'Run, a now depreciated asset on the Unity storefront. The reason why this is depreciated is that it was originally released in 2011 and is no longer being supported by the developer. The reason being is perhaps they were able to obtain this game for free. That, and it would help buffer against someone finding the original asset and calling the dev out for being exactly what they are. I was able to find the game at indiedb.com, and yes, these two games are most definitely another pair of asset flips. And just like any television infomercial out in the world, I have to utter the phrase, "But wait, there's more." Because our scarlet waterfowl still wasn't able to merely leave well enough alone. Oh no, there's yet one more maddening piece of flotsam to throw onto the pyre. Rage Parking Simulator 2016, a simple time-soak mobile game in which one attempts to park a car without hitting anything along the way. With a steering wheel that you have to control with your mouse and a simple forward or reverse, this game is about as basic mobile as one can get, and indeed the original is named simply 2D Parking Simulator, a Unity asset store item developed by Loonybits. Now, there are going to be some new viewers, and possibly some that are already subscribers, that are wondering what's the big deal. Well, I'll tell you. Indie devs typically work extremely hard to be able to produce a game that they hope we will enjoy. Some do it for the intellectual challenge. Others do it because it's something they have a genuine interest in pursuing as a career, but more often than not, the one pervasive attribute that indie devs share with gamers is a love of gaming. There's usually a passion there, a drive to produce something that others will enjoy. Asset flippers are the exact opposite of this. There is no passion, no drive, no desire to create whatsoever. Asset flippers purchase whatever package from the Unity Asset Store or any of the other platform shops for developers and rebrand the content as their own and then repost the games usually and most commonly in an unaltered state for sale for a ridiculously low price. And more often than not, they don't make their money off of the game sales. They earn money from the trading cards. You see, each time there is a trading card transaction, Valve takes a cut. Out of that cut, there is 10% earmarked for the original developer. This is where these asset flippers make their money, not from the game sales, but from a robust and active trading card system on Steam. In addition to that, every single one of these asset flips that are present on any digital distribution storefront clutter the inventory. It muddies the water, if you will, decreasing visibility for honest and legitimate games who are all fighting for a shred of recognition in a system that has become overrun with a sea of lowest common denominator chaff. So avoid these games, ladies and gentlemen. They don't deserve your time or your money. Reserve that for a game that took actual effort from someone who cares more about gaming than to treat it as a mindless cash-in. And while we're at it, thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Please do like and share. Spread the news of these games and their substandard status far and wide. Tell your friends, tell your enemies, tell people you happen to wander by on the street. But before you do that, make sure to hit those like and share buttons down below. Post this on Twitter, Reddit, Facebook, Vote, everywhere you can post a link. Send a message to asset flippers like these that their shameless and blatant greed will not be tolerated any longer. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit subscribe before you go tweeting about this video. Also, links to my Patreon, Twitter, and Facebook, and everything else are in the description down below. Please do make use of them. And thanks for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I know I already said it once, but I can't ever say it enough. This has been Sid Alpha, and I'll see you next time.